2069 to 2077, one of the most important time periods of human history, where we were bound to our solar system no longer, where we saw worlds never before seen, where a new possible future for humanity was discovered. The Observer 4 mission. New worlds were within a reach, but we could only watch them from afar. Thousands of images and other scientific measurements were taken during the Observer 4 mission. But even with all of this revolutionary data, there was still something missing. More could be done. 2140, 37 years after the end of the Observer 4 mission, a new journey. The Omega Project, the second step towards a manned mission. The Omega Project is the second extrasolar mission designed to explore the Kites system, comprised of 8 spacecrafts and other complementary probes built to survey the atmosphere, surface and composition of the Kites worlds, either by traversing the surface directly using rovers, observing them from afar via reconnaissance orbiters, or by descending through their atmosphere using landers. Using these 3 types of spacecraft, the Omega Project was able to discover what the Observer 4 couldn't, due to the project's longer mission times and specialized engineering. These discoveries and advancements include the full mapping of the terrestrial worlds and their moons, the further collection of electromagnetic waves and their conversion into sound, the first detailed images of surface features via planetary rovers and landers, the first sound recordings of the terrestrial planets and moons of the Jovian planets. Further monitoring of the atmospheres belonging to the Jovian planets via the Tempestor's 81 and Lambda 85 reconnaissance orbiters. The further monitoring and study of Chi Rulis's ring system via the Tempestor's 81 reconnaissance orbiter. The exploration of Sekhmet by the Omega 85 partner orbiter. The discovery of new moons and natural satellites. first images of extraterrestrial life and the exploration of potentially habitable natural satellites, and much more. Delta 86, Upsilon 87 and Glacis 89. Three terrestrial rovers built to withstand the cold temperatures of the outer world. The focus for 5 stones and 4 inches. Built to survive Aniket, Tartarus and Chesmu respectively. Inner world mission, found to be shorter than their contemporaries. Along with the terrestrial planets, the Jovian planets were also studied. Pioneer and Helios, with help from their specialized landers, Tempestus 81 and Lander 85, have discovered and mapped moons never before seen. A great example of this is the mapping and exploration of Metallus, a natural satellite of Helios, using the Titan 85 atmospheric entry lander. As one of the two atmospheric landers of the Omega project, the Phaethon 85 spacecraft was tasked with landing on the surface of one of many natural satellites. In particular, Phaethon 85 was tasked with the atmospheric recording of Nefertum, a natural satellite of Helios. With a radius of 2,638 kilometers, Nefertum was chosen as a destination due to its affinity and similarity to Titan. Both moons possess a significant atmosphere opaque enough to hide its surface features, along with a prebiotic environment. Using the Phaethon 85 lander, we have been able to record the winds of Nefertum. Acoustic microphones, Phaethon 85 was designed to record the atmospheric noise during its descent and landing. This audio was later used to calculate the wind speed of Nefertum. After landing, Phaethon 85 began drilling into Nefertum's surface. During the drilling process, Phaethon 85 also took images of Nefertum's surface features.
20 minutes of silence.